And we looked at how we could have a big campaign to work on the 16 days of activism, but not just a talk show, not just a handball thing, something that is really going to be giving us an impact on the ground. And we looked, we've done some meetings, done a lot of consultations together with the Brigadier and the relevant stakeholders. And we looked at the high rate of violence, domestic violence at our police station, crime against women and children, missing persons, gender-based violence, child neglect, and abuse of older persons. And when we looked at what the common thing was that made our police station such a high reported crimes against women center, substance abuse was one of the critical issues that came up. Drugs was one of the issues. And we needed to look at how are we going to make an impact, because we've done door-to-door about 6 weeks ago where we were doing handballs together with community safety and the police station here. We've done marches, we've done all of those things, but we continually still had this high rate of domestic violence. So we needed to look at something that's going to have a greater impact, that is going to be service delivery based on the ground to the people. And so the campaign objective is basically to be able to access the services of government, as well as promote an impact instead of a once-off rescue operation. We always reactive more than proactive. So a lot of our interventions is always after a child was murdered, after a domestic violence case where someone was murdered, the whole community gets together and we kind of look for interventions. This one was basically to have services on the ground, to drive change through sustainable monthly follow-up. So when we look at where we want to do the program, the drive of monthly follow-ups is to go back there and then move the operation to another area. So we've had a conversation in looking at our hotspots in the community. And we spoke to Brigadier and we identified three hotspots in Eldorado Park where most of the domestic violence and crime was high. The one hotspot was Extension 1 around the flats, and I think our last murder of the domestic violence murder case 2 weeks ago was in Extension 1. The next one is Cassidor, and the last one was Extension 8, which was our high hotspot areas. So what we decided was for that week of domestic, the 16 days of activism, was to take services to the ground to that three specific areas. And our expected outcomes will be reduction of social ills, access to relevant services in the community, and safe and secure community environment. Also empowering the community to know that they can access the services. The identified social ills that we identified in our community, the critical ones, was substance abuse. And everything basically is based around substance abuse in our community. We've identified the local partners that is in the community, because we constantly say we don't have resources. We do have relevant departments in our community. And then we looked at the relevant government departments that needs to be part of it. We looked at domestic violence as the other one, looked at our critical stakeholders from local as well as government. We looked at child neglect, children in need of care and protection. I know SASA is one of our critical stakeholders here with regards to the abuse of the SASA grants, and moms go out and use that money to buy substance and then the child goes into neglect. We look at all our critical stakeholders for the DSD, SAPS, Child Welfare, SASA, NPA, Community Safety, and the Child Protection Unit. We look at sexual violence against women and children. Who's our critical stakeholders? We know that based in the community. We will have our first gazebo, obviously, will be to capture data of everyone that comes here. So at the end of the day, we will be able to have a database of how many people tap into the service for that day. When they move from the first gazebo, if they needed a protection order or an affidavit to be able to place someone involuntarily into a rehab, the police gazebo will be there. They'll be able to get an affidavit on the ground right there at the service delivery point. If we need to take them so that we can get the protection order, NPA will be part of it. If we need the child protection unit to go out and do an assessment at the house, all the services will be there. If it's someone that needs to go to rehabilitation, we've already identified with provincial Department of Social Development for that week how many spaces at rehabilitation facilities will be available to us. So it means if I come and say, I'm on drugs, I need help, you will get help today. A psychosocial report will be done by Department of Social Development. We will have the rehabilitation facility say, okay, you are male, 18 and over, at that Warnock Hospital, at that we have secured 5 spaces. So you number one. By the end of that day, we need to have placed people into rehab. We need to have help women that is in domestic violence relationships. SASA will be there in saying, okay, here's a report about a mother abusing their SASA card. This is it. At the same time, SACS will be there giving an awareness presentation on the different and various drugs available on the market. We're looking at our SACS tent having the various kind of drug display there with information on what is available, how to report it. If there's people in that specific hotspots that wants to give a tip off for that time, we will have people from our SACS department will, that will be there. Our counselors, our faith-based organizations will be there giving counseling wherever counseling is needed. And so it is a hands-on operation for that week where people will be able to tap into the relevant services that they require. The resources that we require for that week, obviously, we need to look around is the gazebos, but when we look at the services coming, if you look at SASA, SASA must have their own gazebo. SACS will have their own gazebo. Department of Social Development will come with their own gazebo. As a team, we will provide tables and chairs, water, and that kind of thing. So for the week, as we move around, the gazebos and things will be moved to the next spot. Our infrastructure, we have looked at the hotspots, and we're tapping into NGOs and churches that's close to the area where we will be so that we can have power points, we can have toilet facilities, so that people can actually see the services of what every department is actually on the ground and they can tap into that thing. So it becomes an effective one. You can go down. That one is the last one, but if we look at our launch, I've added onto it, so we can go on. Our launch is supposed to take place on the 25th of November. However, there is so much activity that is happening on the 25th, so we thought about doing it on Saturday morning, the 26th, from 9 o'clock to 11 o'clock. So the police station is our focal point of the whole campaign. And we were looking at our of the launch. And we will then release balloons in honor of their family member that was harmed by all kinds of violence against our women and children. On the main road, we will have 8 trees from towards the police station from this side up, and 8 trees from that side up with white bandages on, so that we can have visibility that the police station becomes the focus and the central point of this is where our help is from. This is our center that we're going to have. And as the days unfold, we will be unbandaging some of those trees. So the launch is basically, as the leadership, we will be bandaging on the day of the launch. We will be assisting to release those balloons. How are we going to measure the impact? There will be a pre-questioning when the community comes to the first gazebo on the first day. There will be a pre. At the end, a questionnaire. At the end of it, after services have been delivered, we will also have a questionnaire and ensure that people have received, so that we can have an impact assessment on how the program went. This has been presented to Department of Social Development as well, because they are one of the key and critical stakeholders when it comes to the essential services with social workers and that. They're very excited about it. If it works in El Dorado,